Hello, everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays FTL. We've had some good runs lately, we've had some bad runs, but we've also had some off-camera runs that I typically record while I'm rendering other stuff or, while Kate is streaming. And on easy, I was actually able to get a victory with the Mantis Cruiser, which unlocks the Slug Cruiser. So we now are only one ship away from getting all of the Type A unlocks, except for the Crystal Cruiser, which I should really just spoil it for myself and read up the quest line for it at this point, because I feel like I could probably get it if I actually just knew how to actually follow the dialogue boxes. But we're gonna try playing as the Slug Cruiser. I've done one run on easy and I lost, so that doesn't really bode well for this. But what's cool about the Slug Cruiser? It's renowned as maybe one of the worst ships in the game from what I've been able to gather from Twitter. We're gonna play on normal just because I don't wanna get too accustomed to the crazy scrap rewards of easy. Although I lost on easy, I had like literally 800 or 900 scrap when I lost. I just didn't find a store, so I was like, oh, well, here it goes, or I'm dead. So, the Man of War starts with two Sloth crew members, but does not have sensors, but the Sloth, or not the Sloths, that would be awesome though. The Slugs have their telekinetic or psychic ability, which allows them to sense where crew members are on the enemy ship. So you can use your dual lasers and your breaching bomb to take down enemy shields, and then the anti-bio beam to actually kill them. So it's almost like having a crew teleporter, and you go in their ship and actually murder everybody, but instead it's you don't actually have to go onto their ship, which is good because you don't have very many crew members. So I already got kill three enemy crew members with one shot with the anti-bio beam on easy. We can also get jump to 30 nebula locations before sector 8. That seems crazy, but also I guess this ship is good in nebula, so we can definitely try to get that. Or while using the Slug Cruiser, have vision of every room of the enemy ship without functioning sensors. I don't even know how to do that. Maybe a really small ship beats me. Anyway, or a crew teleporter would totally work as well. But anyway, we're gonna get started here. Apologies for the super long intro, but just in case you haven't seen that, or this ship before, I thought that would be a good thing to do. So I'm gonna put dual lasers in our number one position here, because if this goes down, the anti-bio beam can't do any damage. It can't do hull damage to begin with, but it also can't get through enemy shields. So we wanna make sure that our dual lasers are in the primary spot here. So maybe we'll jump over here quickly and we'll try to hit up as many nebula locations as we can. I don't believe I'm even going to survive to Sector 8. We'll try it though. Oh good, hacking right off the bat. Good thing it only hacked the med bay. The one thing you want to keep in mind using the anti-bio beam here, we're going to shoot at their weapons first and then we'll get shields next. Oh, I was paused there for a second. The one thing you want to keep in mind, ah, come on. Come on. We might still go on weapons just because it's a little scary. Yeah, let's give it a try. Alright, the one thing you want to keep in mind with this anti-bio beam is, you want to make sure that you take out the enemy medbay as soon as possible, because if they have a medbay, then it's going to be very, very difficult for you to actually kill them. Whereas, with the anti-bio beam active, you can take them out very, very easily. I think it does like 60 crew damage. Yeah, so you only need to hit humans, for example, twice to kill them, less if you hit them with a couple of laser shots as well, and NGs go down even easier. It is going to be difficult for us to prevent the enemies from getting away if they choose to, but the anti-bio beam does do a darn good job at taking out enemy crew members. And it's a pretty large beam, so you can actually be very creative. You can almost play it like a little bit of a puzzle game, and here we go. Play it like a little bit of a puzzle game and try to get like all of the enemy crew members in like one line so you can hit them with the beam. Overall, I do kind of agree that this seems like a little bit of a weaker ship, all things considered though. It's very difficult to do hull damage. When you get the breaching bomb active, it's pretty nice, but I guess we have to go to the store, unfortunately. Is it really worth jumping to this nebula location? I don't think so. I think we'll just try to hit this like beacon-rich area over here instead. We might still be able to get to the nebula location. We want to go to nebulas anyway, so we'll probably be able to get like 10 or 12 jumps from each one of those. Promise to help, sure. Simply fire on the defense system from a distance. Hey, we got 8 scrap for free, which is probably less than you would expect to get from your average combat encounter, but that's still okay. I mean, here's the thing. It's not really great to be going up against drone ships like this because the anti-bio beam doesn't do anything. But 7 scrap is garbage. What do they have? They have like a beam and what looks to be another laser. I could always use a breaching bomb. You know what? Let's just take the 7 scrap. I'm gonna try to play a little bit more cautiously, and maybe that'll end up working out for me in the long term. So, I should mention, by the way, this is exactly the same ship, basically, so we should get the anti-bio beam off, put the breaching bomb on instead. Breaching bomb's a really good weapon when it actually works, and especially against crew members, because, like, if you drop a breaching bomb on, like, their weapons room, they can't repair their weapons. It doesn't do very much actual damage to them. I am going to use a bomb here, even though normally I would prefer not to, especially when it just wastes itself like that. It forces them to fix the breach before they can actually fix the system. So in particular, if you drop this on something like the enemy medbay, you're going to be in a good position. We will have a solar flare here. What I wanted to talk about, just as we open up all these doors, basically, to probably vent any possible fire. There's a much easier way to do this, but I am not a clever man. We have an augment. I think it's called, like, Slug Repair Gel. And the way that the augment works is that if there's a breach, then we just have like a thick mucusy gel that actually stops breaches from staying open. It seals them automatically. We can sell it for 30 scrap. We have a quest marker here. We can sell it for 30 scrap, or we could keep it. I don't know which is the best. A lot of people have told me that the best thing to do is sell it. So I don't think I'll be going to a store on this sector. What I will do is pick up that second bar of shields as soon as possible, and we'll have to depower engines a little bit to make that work, but having a second bar of shields protects us quite nicely against lasers, ions, stuff like that. Missiles are going to be a sore spot for us, as they always are, but luckily we only have lasers here. That is, I think they have 3 laser shots, so that was stupid of me to keep my breaching bomb out like that, but since we usually fire 2 lasers, or we fire the dual laser twice, it should be okay to basically coincide exactly with when the anti-bio beam is ready. So they've got a pretty big assortment of crew members here. Oh, we did at least do that, so we can hit them like so. This will hurt them, but it's not going to hurt any of their systems. They do fire 3 shots at a time, which is, you know, gives them definitely the potentiality of breaking through our shields here. Except when one of them misses, which is wonderful. And we seem to be getting basically one miss every time as well. But all we have to do is kill their crew. What you want to do is kill their crew and damage a system. Because that forces their pilot then to leave that room so they can't actually get their FTL charged up. And so as you can see, this Mantis here is still like, well, if they wanted to escape, I probably couldn't stop them. So we're going to have to hopefully take out something there. Well, so yeah, we did some damage to him and the piloting system in the interim period, which is nice. And this should keep them from getting away, not that they've even started to try, although they absolutely should. And then the anti-bio beam will tear him up here. Not quite dead yet, will be soon though. What are your priorities as the slug cruiser? Well, you know, I don't know why you're asking me, this is only my second run. I'm gonna try to make it work, but for me, a big part of it, why would I ever decline a free NG crew member? Does he have any skills? Nope, so he will be our weapons personnel. I think getting another weapon that actually allows you to do system damage, not necessarily hull damage, because you want to make sure that if possible you kill the crew instead of the hull, because you get better scrap rewards there. All right, that quest was not so great. One jump here. I think I'm gonna play it safe here, and it'll cost us a little extra fuel, but we'll definitely be able to make it back if we do it this way. Yeah, that was... I'm just gonna leave. I'm content with our rewards from this first sector. Hopefully we'll be able to jump towards Nebulas here, demand the surrender of their goods. They don't have a missile. They have a... Oh, they're gonna try to escape. So it looks like they have like a 2-shot laser. And this might be a situation where it's better to use the breaching bomb and we could like breach the piloting system or breach the oxygen. A breach the clone bay would be good. But if we can just like hurt their engines a little bit more, and maybe we can stop them. We're on sector 1, so it should take them a while to get away. So let's just make sure we hit them like so. And you know what? I am actually tempted to use the breaching bomb here quickly. And I think we'll drop the breaching bomb on the engine system. It'll do some damage to that crew member who's trying to repair it. But also it'll open a breach, which will then make it basically impossible to deal with. So I think that's smart. Now they'll have to send a crew member in to deal with that, and we can just focus on that crew member or, you know, various other things. We can shoot the pilot system a little bit here, keep everybody busy, and do some damage to everybody as well. The problem is the clone bay is going to stay active, so actually maybe I should take a shot at that while I have the chance. They just got somebody alive again, and 2 people are going to try to repair this. Let's see if we can... We took out one of them, so they're going to have to repair this clone bay. See, it's a little bit more of a puzzle gamey type thing, isn't it? That's why I kind of like this ship, even though apparently it's bad. The real question here is whether or not I'm actually going to be able to kill the enemies before breaking their hull? And that's a darn good question. I'm gonna try like this, and I think this will still hit that crew member as he walks out. Oh, okay, we got one as he was trying to repair the clone bay. Now all we gotta do is maybe sneak one more shot in here. And he's dead, so we win, right? Yeah, okay, we got a free defense drone Mark II, which is pretty good. And, you know, it was the right decision to not go to this beacon. There's only, unfortunately, two nebulas, and there's actually no way for us to get to both of them, but the only way for us to get, well, one of the only ways for us to get to one of them is to come down this way, so we'll try that. I'd say the first sector went totally fine. But, obviously, could have been better. We didn't necessarily get all the scrap rewards that I would have wanted, but I'm happy to be alive with two bars of shields and doing relatively well. We are going to attack the slaver scum here. The nice thing about the anti-bio beam that you might not normally anticipate is that it actually does, despite not being able to break through enemy shields, it does do damage, and a decent amount of damage, because remember, it has zero chance to miss, to Zoltan energy shields. So, you know, as you can see right there, that took off like half of the Zoltan energy shield. It's not amazing, but it's good enough. Now, all that we have to worry about is how good that enemy beam is, and I imagine we're about to find out. Or maybe not. So just wait a second for the anti-beam to be ready, or anti-bio beam, I should say, to be ready. It looks like they can't really do any damage to us, so I'm going to focus on hitting up that med bay, and then hopefully we can hit both of them with this laser. Yeah, I think that actually totally worked. We can buy sensor systems, by the way, in the shops that we come across. Our next anti-bio beam dual laser combo should be enough to take them out. And we might focus on getting another bar of weapons just so we can get Breaching Bomb working more effectively. This should kill them, I think. Yep. And we got a rock crew member there, which is actually awesome. Getting that extra bar of weapons up means we can use the Breaching Bomb, which is nice because that's very important to kind of keep them repairing stuff so that we can focus on just killing them. That being said, we'd also love to get Explosives Replicator because that gives us a 50% chance of not using a missile every time we use that bomb. I had that on my last run. I didn't win, but I had it on my last run, and that made things much easier, I think, on me in the long term. And in the short term, for that matter. But we're seeing those like better scrap rewards from using the anti-bio beam, so I'm feeling pretty good. They don't have a missile launcher, but they do have three lasers. I'm just going to accept their bribe. I'm trying to play a little bit more cautiously, realizing there's no shame in running away from a fight. That might hurt you. Even if you would win, it might be nice to, you know, just not have to fight, not take more hull damage than you'd get in proportional scrap rewards. So we got nothing from that. I clicked through it as quickly as I could because that event has never given me anything. I think you need maybe sensors to get that. Investigate the battlefield, and nothing is there. There is a store, and that is something that I want to visit because I'm probably going to need to invest in some fuel. Try to shield their ship with yours. I will do that. Oftentimes that does end up hurting me, but it doesn't appear that there was a fire there, so let's head to the store quickly. I don't want to sell anything, so I probably won't be buying anything except fuel. Sensors would be nice, I guess, but we don't really need it. Instead, we'll just buy all 7 fuel, and we've got 23 scrap left to go. Keep moving on. We haven't really benefited too much from being on this sector so far, but hopefully in this situation, we'll be able to do that. Because luckily, we are dealing with an enemy ship that only has one bar of shield. So I'm thinking we'll actually drop a breaching bomb on their weapons, just to hopefully keep them from being able to fire too many missiles. They did get one missile off, which was kind of expected. Now I'm just going to wait. Oh, okay, we'll get our NG in there to fix that. I'm just going to wait for an asteroid to hit them. One hit us. Where's the... There it is. Okay, so we're going to dual laser their shields quickly just to keep those offline. And we're going to anti-bio the people that are fixing up the weapons here. So that's going to be tedious for them. So now all asteroids are going to hurt them. I don't need to use another breaching bomb. I'd rather save my missiles if it's at all possible. And the asteroids are just going to tear them apart. So dual laser this time. I'm gonna keep this on weapons just because that missile would be terrible if it actually lands. Now they're trying to get away, but their piloting system is too broken. Oh, come on. Stay in one area. We're gonna drop a dual laser like this. Oh, I accidentally killed their ship. Should have just let the asteroids do it for me, but I wanted to make sure that I had complete control. Unfortunately, I completely controlled the collision into their death, so that was a weird and half-aborted aviation joke there. That doesn't even make any sense. I'm not even an aviation enthusiast. They have a laser and a beam, which means this should be a super easy fight for us. Also a small ship, which is a great asset when you're using the anti-bio beam. So we're going to go on their shields ASAP. Oh, that miss doesn't really matter. Again, I'm not going to use these breaching bombs prodigiously until it's either absolutely necessary because enemies have more than one bar of shields, or more than two bars of shields, technically, or until we get an explosives replicator, which is fairly frequently found, but, you know. What do we need on this run? What's our most urgent, pressing concern? We start with second level of doors. I'm not sure if people noticed that already. It's nice, though. It's very nice to have a second level of doors. I think I killed one of the crew members there. He must have been previously weakened, which is kind of crazy. But, wow, they died so easily. More missile defense is basically what I'm thinking we need. So, unless I can find a drone control unit before we leave the sector, I'll probably focus all of our remaining scrap on upping our dodge chance from a paltry 15, maybe up to 25 is the best we could hope for, with like... The best or the optimal scrap yield would be the way that I would put it, I suppose. No medbay on the ship. There is a crew teleporter. We don't have a mantis, but we should just be able to vent them out because we start with second level of doors. Another thing that we could do is actually send our NG in here to the door room. Just mess with them a little bit harder. It'll lower our dodge chance to zero if we take our slug out of that room. And it's going to be a very difficult venting process. I think we're going to... put our energy back in here, and we're gonna send our Rockman to help fight. Now, what do we do here? Breaching bomb on shields. Their weapons are a little bit less scary than when they had missiles, so I think this is fine. Good, their shields are hurt. Let's now go on their weapons with our laser. And good, we took out their major laser before, not to accidentally make a music reference, but before things became too difficult. Rockman's gonna, well, there's no real point to putting you in the medbay for now, is there? We're gonna dual laser shields again, just to keep those offline. Let's try to avoid accidentally killing their ship this time. So their mantis is dead. This is gonna I love when the guy's just like, aw, shit, there must be a breach in there. That is not what I would focus on as my number one priority. But maybe he feels a little bit differently about things. Look, yeah, this is the best. He's just like running around. Like a human with his head cut off. He's gonna be dead here. No question about it. We actually got a Mantis crew member there, which is awesome. I depowered oxygen for a second just to get our people healed up. Does the Mantis... he has no skills. That's fine. He will become our permanent door personnel plus, you know, roving fighter, basically. Alright, everyone's back to full HP. Make sure to get oxygen powered up so you don't accidentally kill everybody on board the ship. Good advice. There's a distress beacon. And we can go to these in any order, so I want to hit the distress beacon first. It's usually a higher yield, but also greater risk. 5 damage to our hull, huh? No fires, though, so that's okay. And we can go here and then still to the exit. It's a little risky, but... Alright, it's not risky. It was close, but we'll be fine. So we are dealing with a cloaked drone ship. It's actually not that bad. It sucks because it's going to take us a while here, but... you know what? That actually is a heavy ion, so it's possible their beam could get through and do some damage here. That's a little scary. And, no, maybe not. Their breaching, or sorry, I should say our breaching bomb is actually pretty ineffective. Obviously, the anti-bio beam is worthless, which is why I hate fighting drones, as this ship, or as the Mantis Cruiser for that matter. But the breaching bomb is pretty bad as well, because they already don't need oxygen, and breaching bomb Mark 1, it either does 1 or 0 damage to... it does 1 system damage, which is not very much. So, our weapon combination is pretty ineffectual against drones. If I ever get the opportunity to just take scrap without fighting them, like I did earlier in the run, I think that that's actually a pretty smart idea. Rather than, kind of... especially once they actually get some bars of shields up, and it's gonna be very difficult to break them. Anyway. Like, if they have 2 bars of shields, there's just nothing I can do, because I'll have to use, like, 10 breaching bombs or something. Especially if they start missing, which the dodge chance on those fucking drones is so high, so that's likely to happen. 2 fuel for 2 drone parts is a bad trade. Next sector, we're gonna take NG Homeworlds. We do have an NG crew member now. Hopefully that'll give us some blue situations. I just want to see if maybe... hey, there is a store, so I think maybe we'll jump to 1 beacon, then we'll go to the store. Hopefully I don't die on this beacon, because this should allow me... nah, it's the opposite, actually. I will buy 6 fuel for 12 scrap, though. And, oh, there's another store. This is a very store-rich area. I do still want to up our dodge chance, but keep in mind we can maybe get a drone control unit. No, we can't actually, but that's fine too. Crew teleporter. It's very tempting, isn't it? With an anti-bio beam and a crew teleporter. But I would like to get a clone bay in conjunction with it. But I do think that this is kind of a cool idea. I think I may sell this defense drone. I'd prefer defense 1 anyway, as many people have told me. Even though that is great missile defense, I'll admit. I think I'm gonna buy the crew teleporter. I'm gonna repair our hull a little bit. Couldn't buy the clone bay anyway without... you know what? I'm gonna sell the slug repair gel. And we'll buy the clone bay. Alright. So, this is a weird one. I'll admit. But, now our Mantis can go over. And maybe even our Rockman can head over there. Obviously, he's super slow. But I think using them in conjunction with what we've got going on here, it's gonna be a tall order. I'll admit. Because I'm gonna have to focus on a lot of different things at the same time, but I think this might be the best way to ensure that we can kill, you know, enemy crew as easily as possible. So we don't have any power in our, we can depower our breaching bomb and power up our teleporter, and hopefully we'll get enough scrap here to be, okay with that. And basically we'll come over here and start fighting this NG. The only problem is now the anti-bio beam, will kill our crew members, which is actually totally fine because we have a clone bay. Okay, maybe this is easy as hell, actually. Maybe this is wonderful. That caused no problems whatsoever. We just got a fuck ton of scrap as a result. Come on back now. We're gonna get our reactor powered up, two more, so that we can still keep our clone bay active as well as our breaching bomb. And that's great. Yeah, this is actually awesome. Okay. You can, yeah, okay, perfect. Alright, this is really cool. A little weird, but cool nonetheless. We have a quest, we have two quest markers. Yeah, so we're gonna bum rush those as quickly as we can. I really like this ship. We still have terrible missile defense. Luckily, this enemy does not have a missile. So we're gonna teleport on board, and I don't really know where to fight them. I think it maybe is best to fight them in the weapons room. Oh man, why would you send your NG over here to basically just die? So we're gonna anti-bio beam their shields. It doesn't matter if any of our crew members die, because we have the, we got the power, don't we? Oh, we should actually totally go on their med bay. Maybe we'll just breach the med bay with a bomb quickly. Oh, get out of there, Mantis. Almost killed my own Mantis crew member. That's okay, though. So we're gonna dual laser the shields. Anti-bio beam. We're just gonna give it a second here to figure out where we're gonna use that anti-bio beam. We're gonna use it to kill our own crew member and the crew member there that's fighting us, and the crew member in the med bay. Alright, so that gave us an achievement. I'm not sure what that achievement is actually for, but we got it. Alright, so your shields are completely out. Next anti-bio beam will absolutely kill you. You know what, we might as well try to get our Rockman killed in the process here. I think. Yeah, we'll see. If he dies, great. We'll actually just use an anti-bio beam. It'll lower his skills a little bit, but then he'll come back to life. We got a burst laser Mark 1. He's coming back, good. Burst laser Mark 1 fires two shots for two power, which is terrible. But we have it. Yeah, okay, come on back, my Rockman friend, and head to your rooms of choice. Alright, I need to resave where they're supposed to actually be. Why is all of that? I guess it makes sense to have that vented, doesn't it? I'm liking this run. It's unusual. I think you can tell that I'm getting an affinity for teleporter. I almost never used it when I played FTL the first time. The automated platform seems to be damaged. You can likely steal as much fuel as remains. Yeah, steal it. For fuel. What's the downside? That was awesome. It's like, war doesn't justify stealing. I'm trying to save the fucking world here. Alright, so they have missiles. That sucks pretty hard. What we're gonna do is teleport on board into their weapon room. At least two of them will come to fight us. We may also drop a breaching bomb just straight here on the weapon room, just to consistently make sure that they have no fucking chance. Even though that is gonna hurt us, that's gonna take their missile launcher offline. And we're not gonna fire dual lasers yet. Now we are, actually, because anti-bio beam's ready. So we'll dual laser, and then anti-bio beam is gonna hurt us a lot. There's no way around that. But it will also kill all three crew members, thereby making it impossible for their med bay to actually bring anybody back. So Vincent is actually gonna die here, I think. I want him to die. There we go, Vincent has died. And I wanted him to die so we could get back to full HP, basically via the clone bay. All right, Mantis, you come here. I don't think it's necessary to upgrade our teleporter that much more. I would actually like to spend some money on dodge chance now. I think that's, I mean, we need better missile defense, even though we are wrecking enemy faces pretty quickly. But it doesn't... I can't say with authority whether there is or is not a store nearby. So for now, we'll just jump and we'll save our scrap for now. Hopefully we won't get hit by some nasty missile launchers. These guys only have lasers. They're gonna try to get away. What we should do is maybe fight them in the piloting bay this time. They went for our piloting bay. And they have an ion intruder drone, which is unfortunate, but not so bad. I think I'm gonna drop a breaching bomb on their shields, just to make our double lasers a little bit more effective. And get out of there, man. Let him take out the weapons if he wants to. So we're gonna go on their drone control unit, because it's really annoying. And then we're gonna drop an anti-bio beam here and probably kill everybody in that room. Wonderful strategy we've got going on. Oh, there's another crew member left. I had no idea, actually. How much health does he have? A lot. So we're actually not going to... they took out a lot of weapons there. Where are you going to go? What are you going to repair? Shields? Yes. So we'll drop dual lasers there. And then he's going to go repair the drone unit. I guess you should get back in here, Angie. And we'll send our Mantis over. Yeah, the teleporter's done, so... this should allow us to kill him pretty easily. A little bit of a cumbersome fight, but problem solved. We got another quest marker as a result for that. I should probably start reading those so that I can actually, you know, maybe get a gist of what we're supposed to be doing with that. Oh, the quest marker's right here now. Okay. That's fine. Kind of want to invest in some extra, like, dodge power. So that took a lot of our reactor power, but that's okay. Can't really depower anything, so let's go 25. Sure, that's okay. And I expect that this quest beacon will probably provide us with some decent rewards, and what I assume is going to be a difficult fight, which is the entire reason that I went through this, I went through those upgrades to begin with. So we're going to go in on their, going in on their piloting room is really nice because it gives them basically like a 0% dodge chance, and we're not going to take out their weapon anyway, so why don't we go in on the piloting room? You're really going to fight here? That's going to be like terrible for you, human. But we can't let the clone bay go down, so we'll have to distract him. But this allows me to drop a breaching bomb on the weapons, and I do want to take those out as soon as possible because of the whole missile launcher situation. That may have opened a breach, but on a room that I don't really care about. We can keep fighting you in here just as long as we're, they have no medbay, right? Oh, they do have a medbay, okay. Drop this, and then quickly, this is actually a perfect anti-bio beam. We can just do that, kill both of them, and then, almost just want to teleport our people back on board here. Because they can ion stun us, but that's about it. I think we're actually going to just teleport these dudes back. And we'll do our best to make sure that their teleporter just can't become functional. Totally is going to work. We got to hit the medbay then. Because they're going to heal up there. Yep, there they go. They're all dead. Ask about the Mantis ships. Okay, let's read this. The NG emerged victorious from their battles with only minor losses. They message you. Project X-ME56 commissioned by Federation Military Research Division Advanced Stealth Cruiser. Oh, it's a stealth cruiser quest. Project finished during rebellion, unable to reconnect with Federation Military Command. Ask about Mantis ships. Likely ploy by rebels to avoid breaking non-aggression pact with NG. 97.56% likely. Your mission to assist last Federation fleet. Correct. Coordinates. Okay, transmit coordinates. So we got a lot of scrap, fuel, a drone part, and 11 hull points repaired, plus titanium system casing. Titanium system casing is the one that gives us like a 50% chance when we get hit on a system for that system to not take damage. Mostly what I'm psyched about here is that we appear to have gotten a really, really nice amount of scrap. We're back up to 92 despite spending like 50, like 95 on the last sector. We explored the asteroid field here and that turned out very well for us. And I think we're just going to jump to the next sector. And that will only be Sector 4. We're going to go to the Slug-controlled Nebula. It's a wild time to be alive. Now, the question is... there's totally stores around. Okay, I'm excited about that because I might be able to buy something. I got a lot of scrap, and there's nothing really pressing to upgrade. Cloaking would be awesome to pick up. I don't think it's going to be possible. I think we're either going to want to go with the Burst Laser Mark II or the Flat Cannon Mark II. Do we have any? We might want to sell titanium system casing. If we do, then we can get cloaking. Is cloaking that good for us? It is, but it's great missile defense, isn't it? Maybe we do want cloaking. I realize I'm being quiet here. It's because I'm focusing. I need to take a drink of water for a second. At the very least, I'm going to express my my thought process. On the last run, my weapons were... the last Slug Cruiser run on easy, my weapons were dual laser, anti-bio beam, breach one, so exactly what I've got going on right now, plus there was one other weapon, I think it was like an ion bomb or something like that, and I just could not get through enemy shields. Without being able to get through the Rebel flagship shields, anti-bio beam is basically worthless, dual laser is, it does what it can, which is not very much. So... I'm thinking that maybe a flat cannon that shoots 7 shots is way more viable. Mind you, this would mean that I can't buy cloaking, which is drastically going to lower our missile defense. Not lower, but inhibit our missile defense at least. That being said, I still think that basically flat cannon is the right pickup. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to sell the Burst Laser Mark 1. We're going to have to invest a lot into weapon power here. And I could buy nothing. That's okay, though. I think this is the right decision. You might think I'm crazy, but I'm not the only one. And truth be told, it's probably better for us to... Wait... Well, can we get one more bar of weapon power? We can. It might be better for us to have, like, anti-bio beam flat cannon working. But let's check out our ship quickly. Equipment. Anti-bio beam takes 16 seconds. Flak takes 21. And the laser only takes 10. I think we're gonna stick with the situation we've got right now. But, and then we gotta, well, we don't have to jump to another store, we can go around this way again. And then we'll use the flat cannon as an upgrade, because what we've got right now works for us. This might allow me to get to 30 nebula jumps if I do this. Alright, so we're gonna fight. They do have a teleporter, they do have a medbay. That's fine, we have a clone bay, as long as it stays powered up. They have a bomb and a relatively scary laser. We're gonna fight inside of their piloting room. And then we're probably going to drop a... Oh, they actually did go for us here, much to my surprise. We're probably going to drop a breaching bomb on their weapons area, just so they can't use more than one bomb, ideally. Or their laser doesn't work. Either one of those is fine by me. So they're going to run away, and they're going to run away to the med bay. We can't really stop them in the med bay. So what we can do is... no, we're going to wait for a second. Then we're going to breaching bomb the med bay. Like that. And that's gonna really mess with them, because then we can very quickly two-shot, doesn't really matter where, take out their shields, and then anti-bio beam the shit out of them. And they're not quite dead, but they're not doing so hot. Can we kill this guy while he's in the med bay? With two people, I think we can. We can indeed. And they're all dead. We got an awful lot of scrap for that. Come on back now. And that worked out very nicely, I would say. We're not going to get to 30 jumps in here. That was ridiculous of me to even assume that that would be possible. Can't get that bar of reactor power yet. I do want to upgrade clone bay and teleporter if possible, but we have other fish to fry right now. I would still love to be able to... Basically, I have to guarantee that I can get through enemy shields. What's going on here? I didn't look at the first thing. Doesn't really matter. We're going to teleport on board into their piloting room just so we have basically 0% chance to miss. And yeah, we're going to die. That's going to happen, but... Drop a breaching bomb quickly on their weapons, force them to deal with that. Oh, we missed! Even though, I didn't think we would. We did. So they're probably like, yeah, we killed them! Nah, not so fast. Okay, give it a second. Slugs are relatively weak. So we're just gonna get an anti-bio beam like that. That killed one of them, and then we'll just drop a breaching bomb. That almost certainly would have killed that one, but he moved out of the way. I'm actually very impressed, with the way that slug handled that situation. Well done, Slug. That guy's still alive. We could use another breaching bomb. I'm gonna use another breaching bomb just in case this fire gets out of control. He's dead. 44 scrap. Pretty solid. Send our rock man in here to deal with this. Kind of annoying, but that's okay. And remember, we only need to get to, what is it? 30 nebula jumps by Sector 8. Although, I think we've already unlocked the Type B layout of the Slug Cruiser, to be honest with you. Come on, Rockman. There we go. Rockman didn't even take any damage. That's pretty solid of him. I'm feeling good about this run. I'm not saying we're going to beat the Rebel flagship. That's obviously something that is not easy to guarantee. But what I will say is that I feel like things are going relatively well right now. So, I am going to upgrade our weapon power a little bit more. We need another 50 scrap or so, plus the reactor power, to get... the flat cannon actually working, but once we get it, this is going to be the ultimate shield-breaking device. And I'm very excited about that. Let's jump into this one. It's just a little busier over here. Maybe we can get some more beacons. Oh, the clone bay's on fire, huh? Clone bay's on fire. Better put it in the water. Brian Eno? Any Brian Eno fans out there in the audience? Probably. He's big on YouTube. So, I think we'll send... I know that this seems silly. I think we'll send our Mantis over anyway, though. And then we'll open up, hopefully, a breach, at least, in the shield room. This is actually bad, because now our clone bay is not active. Get over. Repair that clone bay ASAP. Otherwise, our Mantis might be dead forever. He's not, which is nice. Get back to your rooms here. Now, do a laser quickly. It totally worked. Best anti-bio beam of all time. It didn't even kill us. All right, so... controlled anti-bio beam there, kept our Mantis alive. That rock man is not long for this world. And, I mean, we could even send our Mantis over there to possibly deal with him, but probably won't be necessary. I don't want to use another breaching bomb if we can avoid it, but they could get that third bar of shields up. No, they're not. And you're dead. 50 scrap for us is actually quite excellent. We'll pick up that extra bar of weapon power, and now, you know, if we're very, very careful about what we do. Is there a breach in the shield room? There's not. I was going to get our Mantis killed just so, you know, he would have more health. It's okay, though. Making a lot of nebula jumps here. Nebular jumps. Three bars of shields, really annoying. We are just going to keep him busy. Again, you know, with the clone bay, we're basically using our crew as, like, suicide borders here, which is fine. I don't know why you would ever send an NG over as a border. That seems, I mean, unless you had no other choice, that seems real silly. So we're going to open up a breach in their shield room, hopefully force somebody to have to go deal with that, otherwise their shields are basically going to go completely out. That was a really nice hit from them, I'll admit. Now, two hits like this, and anti-bio beam, we can just drop like so. Oh, we actually missed the Mantis there. Drop another breaching bomb here, and that's going to force him to deal with some, you know, unwelcome situations. Please don't. 22% chance. One of them missed. Thank God. Okay, give it a second. We're going to open up a breach in their med bay. Yeah, sorry, Angie. Bad day to be you. And this should finish the job. Wonderful. Another 47 scrap. So, you guys, let's close all doors for a second. Let the oxygen come back. Only got one extra bar of reactor power there, so we'll keep that in our engines for now. 34% passive dodge chance is pretty solid. I'm okay with it, at least. And we'll continue jumping. Exit first, but we're going to jump around as many of these nebula beacons as we can. Nothing going on here. Luckily, I have a really nice supply of fuel, so that's okay. Nebulas are great because the rebels get twice as slow, I think. Despite the destruction filling the system, your crewman is able to pick up the faint thoughts of a life form. It looks like they won't last much longer without help. Let's help. Try to clone them before it's too late. Yeah, we got a Mantis who is also a great pilot. A yellow pilot. That's better than our existing pilot. So, you're going to be our new shield personnel. Liu Jun. I hope that pronunciation is not offensive. I didn't intend for it to be. Of course, it would also be nice to have two Mantises as borders instead, but if this pilot's so good, yeah, he gave us an extra 3% dodge chance. Probably won't end up making all the difference in the world, but maybe. A free crew member's a free crew member, though. All right, so nothing going on here, but every free jump through the nebula puts us a little bit... This was a nebula, was it not? I knew we were going to have to fight, but I really thought that was a nebula. The next thing after we get this reactor power, shields. Third bar of shields is basically a prerequisite for that final boss fight, in my opinion. And then after that point, it's augments and maybe cloning if it shows up again. I want to fight the engineer. So if all three of them want to come into the same room, oh, the NG went to pilot. Okay, I mean, it's a smart idea. I can't deny that. We're going to open up a breach on their... almost want to just open it up on their weapons room, even though we're in it. It's the benefit of having the clone bay, right? So they're going to have to fight us faster to replenish that or to fix that. And that's perfect. And now we'll see if the anti-bio beam is all it's cracked up to be. I killed my own crew member there, but it's worth it because there we go. Picked up another 63 scrap. It's two more bars of reactor power, which gives us the flat cannon Mark III. Super exciting. I'm going to let my crew member die, of course, so they can come back with full health. If I end up killing my own crew members with the flat cannon, that's why we have a clone bay. Might want to upgrade the Clone Bay a little bit, not just for the passive heal, but for, you know, we can't get another bar of reactor power. Not just for the passive heal, but also so that we can, get, faster clones. Might end up being important. I realize this makes them worse fighters every time they come back, but it's fine. They're basically just there to keep them busy so they can't repair breaches. And if they survive long enough, even better. But I've been killing them kind of on purpose. Maybe that's a terrible decision. Alright, on this one, we'll go on the weapons room. Just because we can get more crew members in there, hit more people with the anti-bio beam, ideally. And now that we have the flat cannon, we maybe can lay off on the breaching bombs a little bit, but I probably won't. I'm going to try to breach their piloting system just to mess with that guy for now. They'll send a couple people in to repair that, which is exactly what I want, because now, where are you going? Probably the med bay, huh? Yeah, we'll get a breaching bomb set to go there. But first, we'll dual laser, like so. And our oxygen's in a bad place. Why don't we try a little of this? Oh, it worked. Okay, that was really good. All right, engineer, get in here. Fix this oxygen ASAP. And everybody else in their ship's gonna die. Shall we, flat cannon? Let's give it a try, right? And everybody's dead. So we're up to 43 scrap. Is there a breach anywhere that I can kill my crew member on? No? Maybe it's the best idea not to kill him. Yeah, there's a breach here. We'll just let him die. It seems best to send them over when they're at full health because I only have a level 1 teleporter, even if it does lower their fighting skill to basically 0 every time. But I might be a total idiot in saying that. We've already been at this beacon, so we can just come here and wait for our crew member to come back to life. And I would say this is quite an interesting slug cruiser run we've got going on here. Barring any kind of exceptional circumstances, this will be the... I'm going to pick up that extra bar of reactor power. Just for now, we can store it in engines for the extra dodge chance. Yeah, barring any exceptional circumstances, these will be the weapons that we'll be taking into that boss fight against the Rebel flagship if we make it that far. And I'm very pleased with the way things are going so far. So this is going to be the end of Sector 4, if I remember correctly. We're going to head to the abandoned sector. Hopefully there's a big nebula there, but that's going to do it for part 1. No nebulas at all, huh? That's going to do it for part 1. If you enjoyed the episode, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching. And I'll see you in part 2, which will be linked in the video description below, up right away. Thanks for watching. See you next time.